Congressman Plaza, what can we do now? I know that it's too late to get your bill passed. And as Mr. Palafox has said, the DPWH has not completed the mapping, but there's information available from the Field Folks website. Is there anything that we can do today without having to rely on DPWH or Congress to pass a bill?
Ricky, it is unfortunate and sad, and I'm sure Jun Palafox knows about the condition that all the local government units, 14 of them, are signatory to a resolution to the effect that they will prepare, there will be a massive information dissemination down to the barangay level. Until today, I have not heard of any exercise to that effect. So, ang mangyayari po dito, marami po ditong mabibigla. And I don't know if we can really handle should this incident happen.
Mm.
Now, I don't know, on part of the National Disaster Coordinating Council, what efforts have been done to address this issue. Well, probably at this point in time, the Department of Interior and Local Government should come into the picture, call all the local government units within Metro Manila to discuss the possibility of this incident and what are the measures that should be taken in order to mitigate the impact of the earthquake.
But what can we do outside of the government,
I don't know,
Congressman? Because, you know, if we're going to wait for these guys to do something, then the earthquake is going to hit and it'll be too late. I'm wondering if any of you have an idea, you know, what can we do? We ordinary people outside the government, is there anything we can do?
Right.
Ricky, otherwise the private sector can take the initiative. Now, based on the report, all the road system will be severely damaged. So therefore, you will have problems in transporting the equipment. Now,
yeah.
What the government should do, even the Department of Public Works and Highways, should have already a mapping of all the available equipments within Metro Manila.
Right, but sir,
inside Metro Manila.
Yeah, yeah, but I guess I'm not expecting that to happen. But I'm asking either of you, maybe Mr. Palafox, you can ask this. What can we ordinary people do without having to depend on either the DILG or the DPWH or the NDCC?
MMDA. Well, we can start with the individual.
Ricky.
Hold on, sir. Mr. Palafox first.
You could start with the individual. Just like in our company, we have our emergency preparedness manual. And each employee is given a flashlight, a whistle, we have a hammer to break the windows, we have stretchers. Every 10 employees have an emergency kit. And we know where the evacuation area is. Every barangay should have an evacuation area. And then, since I had so many inquiries about all of this after Haiti earthquake, I wrote the president and recommended 60 recommendations and a 10-year program to address this.
Right,
and the
here.
Most immediate would be a structural audit, hydrological audit, and geologic audit of all buildings. Geology, how strong is the soil foundation? Mm. Is it within a fault line or the soil could liquefy? Structural audit, check the buildings whether they follow the specifications, they are within the building code, the structural code of the Philippines.
Mm.
And this could be immediately done, even by the private sector.
Did she get the letter?
January 29, and it was acknowledged by some cabinet members already, like Secretary Gary Telves, who's in the reconstruction, post on the reconstruction, and Secretary Saludo.
Is anyone acting on it, as far as you know?
We had a meeting today with the private sector group and the public sector group, and I brought it up again, and one thing that they have done is the hazard mapping that's been published.
Mm.
But it wasn't a nationwide. It should be down to the barangay level. Mm. Let's say if there's an earthquake. Earthquake, then fire, then you need water, food, emergency shelter, and the reconstruction and rehabilitation. And you look at Metro Manila, we don't even have enough open spaces for evacuation area. Mm. In the evacuation area, you should have the medical facilities, you should have a helipad. And you should have a water retention basin because we lack water and food and so on.
Mm. Congressman Plaza, did you want to say something?
Yes, what I wanted to say is, while I certainly agree that there should be a private initiative, but it is the duty of the state to protect its citizenry. Now, the government, to my mind, should be the lead, but however, if the government is not doing anything to address these issues, then government is now part of the problem. Now, what Jun brought is really very good for all of us. We have to identify areas where we can relocate the victims. But to my mind, if the whole of Metro Manila is in a state of shock, how then can the rescue workers, medical workers,
pass through,
participate in the... So the only way to my mind, if there, who will be the crew to undertake the evacuation? Will it be coming from within Metro Manila or outside of Metro Manila? Then when we extract the people, should we only extract the people within the area in Metro Manila, or we take them out of Metro Manila? Let's say Batangas area, or for the north, you have Bulacan and Pampanga. Because with so many deaths and the lifeline system is totally down, well, I can imagine the whole of Metro Manila would smell like dead rats with dead people, with cadavers. And how are we going to address this? So this is really the main problem. There's so much to be addressed.
All right. Well, gentlemen, thank you so much to Architect Palafox and Congressman Ompong Plaza for sharing your thoughts with us. We hope that the government will listen. The story you've been painting for us is scary enough.
Yeah, and maybe we shouldn't wait for the government to do something. Maybe we in our own communities can do something.
That's not my story, says. That's based on the report.
Yeah.
Correct.
Well, gentlemen, thanks again for coming tonight. It was a pleasure to have you on the program. Okay, scary stuff there. But again, as...
Well, but they're right. But how can you let government act on it when we're in the middle of a campaign? And
yeah, but when it hits, then everybody will say, where was everybody? And at least you had Jun Palafox in Ompong Plaza warning the public.
Sounding the alarm.
Even before tonight, they were doing that. And so we can't say that we weren't warned, because those two gentlemen have been talking about this for at least the last few months. And maybe we in our communities can do something. Again, let's not wait
bring
for...
Bring your whistle.
Let's not wait for the government.
Bring your whistle and flashlight with you all the time.
I better buy one first.